A Wisconsin man accused of killing a 13-year-old girl's parents so he could kidnap her allegedly made up his mind to snatch her after a chance encounter. Jake Patterson,
21,
told investigators he watched Jamie Claus by a school bus that he had stopped behind while driving to work. He faces charges of killing Jamie's parents and kidnapping her on 15 October last year. Jamie escaped last Thursday, after 3 months in captivity, say police. On Monday, a criminal complaint outlined how Mr. Patterson came up with the idea of targeting Jamie. He allegedly told investigators he was driving to his job at a cheese factory one day near the village of Almena, when he spotted Jamie get on a school bus. The charging document quotes Mr. Patterson as saying that when he saw Jamie, he knew that was the girl he was going to take. Mr. Patterson told police he only had worked at the factory for 2 days, and ended up spotting Jamie on one of the 2 mornings he drove to work. The complaint says the accused twice scouted the Claus home near Bering with the plan of taking Jamie, but he abandoned the plot those times because too many people were in the vicinity. The charging document says that when Mr. Patterson eventually stormed the family home by the front door, Jamie and her mother, Denise Claus, took refuge in the bathroom. The pair heard a gunshot and suspected the home invader had killed the father, James Claus. Mr. Patterson allegedly broke down the bathroom door, shot Denise Claus, and bound Jamie's hands and ankles. He then dragged her to his car and threw her in the boot. According to the criminal complaint, Jamie told investigators that Mr. Patterson drove 66 miles, 105 kilometers, to a rural cabin near the small town of Borden, where she was allegedly held until her escape. Once at the Gordon home, Jamie said that Mr. Patterson took all of her clothes, saying he would throw them away. She told police he would sometimes make her hide under his bed when friends or family visited the cabin, making it clear that nobody was to know she was there or bad things would happen to her. Sometimes, Mr. Patterson would make her stay under the bed for up to 12 hours, at a time with no food, water, or bathroom breaks, according to the complaint, and to ensure she was trapped. Jamie told officials he would stack containers with heavy weights around the bed, so she could not move them without his being able to detect it. On 10 January, Jamie said she was able to escape after Mr. Patterson left the house, informing her he would be out for 5 or 6 hours. She told police she was able to move the weights and crawl out of the room. She took a pair of Mr. Patterson's shoes and fled on foot, eventually encountering a NIDHBOUR, who helped her contact police. According to the local officers, who then arrested Mr. Patterson, when he stepped out of his vehicle he said, "I know what this is about. I did it." Two Scandinavian women tourists have been found dead in Morocco, with kids to their necks. The country's interior ministry said, both bodies were found near the town of Inlil in the High Atlas mountain range, near the foot of North Africa's highest peak, Mount Zabko. The women, from Denmark and Norway respectively, have not yet been named. A police investigation has been launched into their deaths, the Interior Ministry statement said. A poacher has been ordered to watch the Disney film Bambi repeatedly after he was convicted of illegally killing hundreds of deer. Missouri hunter David Barry, J.R., must view the film at least once a month during his year-long sentence. He was arrested in August along with two family members for killing the deer, taking their heads and leaving their bodies to rot, prosecutors said. It is reportedly one of the biggest poaching cases in Missouri history. On top of the jail sentence for the illegal deer hunting, Judge Robert George ordered Barry Jr. to view the Walt Disney movie Bambi, with the first viewing being on or before December 24,
2018,
and at least one such viewing each month thereafter, during his spell in prison. The 1,942 cartoon about woodland creatures shows a hunter kill the mother of eponymous deer character Bambi. A months-long investigation, spanning several states, led to the arrest of Barry Jr., his father David Barry, Sr., and his brother Kyle Barry, according to local newspaper, the Springfield Newsletter. While the total number of deer taken illegally is unknown, Lawrence County's conservation agent Andy Barnes said it could be several hundred. Barry Jr. received a year-long sentence in Lawrence County Prison after pleading guilty to illegally taking wildlife. He has also been sentenced to a 120-day term in Barton County Prison for a firearms probation violation, and both he and his father had their hunting privileges revoked for life by the Missouri Conservation Commission. A popular tourist attraction has become the latest Chinese company to show solidarity with Hua's Vice Chief Finance Officer, Meng Wanzhou, who was arrested in Canada on 1 December. Shannon Mountain Scenic Park in Eastern Henan Province said it would waive the $9.65 ticket fee for anyone carrying a Huawei phone. Ms. Meng, who was given bail in Canada, faces extradition to the United States on charges of breaking Iran sanctions. Her case has upped tensions with China. U.S. Huawei phones should grant photos on the mountain, a notice on the Shannon Park's social media account said. We wish friends around the world who support Huawei success in bliss. The offer would last until 29 December, the South China Morning Post reported, but it was met with some criticism among China's social media users, who claimed it was discriminatory. Huawei phone owners are being offered other enticements too. They can get a 20% discount at a bar in Beijing. Seen in Beijing, bring a Huawei phone and get 20% off. Similar to this story we covered yesterday, https://coqxl1iypqlpic, twitter.com/sokrilov. End of Twitter post by @lushinj. At least one firm has threatened to penalize anyone buying Apple products. A few days ago, Manpada Shenzhen, based LED display manufacturer, offered subsidies to any employees buying Huawei phones. It also pledged to fine anyone who bought an Apple iPhone. United States prosecutors alleged Ms. Meng,
46,
used a Huawei subsidiary called Skycom to evade sanctions on Iran between 2009 and 2014. They also allege she publicly misrepresented Skycom as being a separate company from Huawei, and that she deceived banks about the true relationship between the two companies. Ms. Meng, who is the daughter of Huawei's founder, has denied any wrongdoing and said she will contest the allegations. Life of Huawei's high-flying heiress. The United States has been investigating the Chinese telecoms giant, the world's second-largest smartphone maker, since 2016. believing that it used the Skycom to bring the United States manufacturing equipment and millions of dollars in transactions to Iran in violation of sanctions. Ms. Mann's detention comes amid an increasingly acrimonious trade dispute between Washington and Beijing. China is angry at her detention, saying she has not violated any laws. Beijing has threatened severe consequences unless Canada releases the executive. Since her arrest, two Canadians, a former diplomat and a businessman, have been detained in China on suspicion of harming national security. United States President Donald Trump said last week that he might intervene in the United States Justice Department's case against Ms. Mann if it would serve national security interests or help achieve a trade deal with China. If I think it's good for what will be certainly the largest trade deal ever made, which is a very important thing, what's good for national security, I would certainly intervene if I thought it was necessary.